Good afternoon. I am Chief Musician Justin Cody, and I would like to welcome you to our Navy Band Cruisers live stream performance. Featuring some of the Navy's most dynamic performers, the Cruisers perform a mix of pop, rhythm and blues, classic rock, jazz, and more. We have engaged and excited audiences of all ages, all across the nation and abroad, with world-class musicianship and high-energy, fun-filled performances. Today's performance focuses on our musical attitude and discipline. Are you mentally setting yourself up for success? Are you sending the best message to everyone around you? Those who can answer yes have the best possible attitude and discipline. Through music, we are going to demonstrate how attitude and discipline form the foundation for our performances and send the right messages while entertaining audiences. To talk about our first selection, I'd like to introduce our drummer, musician first class, Joseph Ganzelli.
All right, thanks, Justin. Hi, everyone. I'm musician first class, Joe Ganzelli, and I'm fortunate to be the drummer for this amazing band of musicians. So our theme today is reaching success through your attitude and discipline. And I'd like to talk a little bit about how we as musicians can harness these two ideas to create a successful performance. Obviously, it takes a great deal of discipline to be able to devote yourself to getting better at something. I couldn't be more thrilled that you are choosing music as a part of your path to success. As with any career or hobby, having the right attitude is crucial. Whether or not your goal is to play music for a living or simply as a hobby, to succeed in a band, you must have a common desire for excellence and the same standard of commitment. If everyone in your band doesn't share the same attitude for achieving your goals, then it makes things so much harder. Music can be frustrating at times, but it could also be incredibly rewarding. The old saying that you're only as strong as your weakest link holds some merit here. Our band here today is seven people with very different personalities and attitudes, and when we perform, everyone is giving 150% of their energy to the music. And if one person were to bring a negative attitude to the band or not give it their all, the entire musical product would suffer. And sometimes that happens. People have bad days. It happens in every band and in every occupation. But are you able to rise above it and take your group to the next level? Every time I sit at these drums, I play as if it's the last time I'm ever going to play. I take musical risks, but know when to just lay down a great groove and not get in the way of the rest of the band. At the core, that's discipline and attitude working together. This first song we're gonna play has many ups and downs, mood changes, time signature changes, and can get tricky if you're not thinking ahead. Everyone has to be mentally disciplined in their playing to successfully transition through each section of this tune. We hope you enjoy this one as much as we do playing it. This is called Jake to the Bone by Toto.
Thank you. Again, that was Jake to the Bone, Toto. I'm musician first class Trevor Shiflett, and I play guitar for the group. As Emuan Ganzelli touched on, approaching music with a positive attitude and discipline is a great start to earning success in the field. However, I'd like to talk about a different kind of attitude. In Jake to the Bone, there are a few different sections that have very distinct sounds or attitudes that differ from each other. The main melody has a heavy funk sound and is played with a lot of attitude. The guitar solo, however, extends or stretches the time by drastically slowing down the tempo and feel, becoming very smooth and spacious. You probably heard me change the way I played to match the new texture, using longer notes and more legato phrasing. This change of attitude and the way we play things is extremely important in music and adds direction and interest to what we play. While we should always be aware of what sounds we make, playing with our attitude and feelings instead of critically analyzing every note we produce is a great way to tap into the emotion we are trying to convey to our listeners and create a sonic experience that evokes a deeper response in our audiences. I'd like to introduce our trumpet player now, musician first class David Smith, to talk about our next selection. Take it to the bridge, Dave.
Thank you. I'm musician first class David Smith, and I'm very grateful to be here. In order to get anywhere in life, you must have the right attitude towards the task at hand. Once you've attained the right attitude, the discipline to finish the task will follow. In order for me to even get to the level of playing to be in this band, I had to adopt a positive attitude towards learning from my band directors. This came quite naturally for me since I loved band class, but in order to grow beyond my school studies, it required me to be disciplined about being a musician. This meant practicing skills, working on solo literature, transcribing solos, writing arrangements, and studying the greats, all of which I still do. And all of these activities mean that your commitment has to go beyond the classroom. Once you've accepted this principle, you will be able to go far in any field you decide to pursue. You always have a choice. You can choose the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. This next tune is an arrangement of a song made popular in the New Orleans music tradition. This is a very popular jazz standard performed by many second line parade groups, brass bands, and jazz ensembles. I first heard this tune performed by the great Louis Armstrong. Even though the harmony and melody are relatively simple, it requires the band to have the right attitude so they can share the joy of music through this song. This is When the Saints Go Marching In.
When the sun Marching in. Oh, when the saints go marching in, you know we want to be in that number. When the saints go
Thank you. We hope that you are enjoying our performance so far. For the next selection, we chose a piece that demonstrates an interesting combination of attitude and discipline. At its core, this piece is a groovy funk tune that makes you want to dance. If we don't accomplish that, we failed our mission. But underneath that funk groove is a disciplined, metronomic precision that has to be mastered in order to create the right feel. This piece required practicing very slowly with a metronome for hours and hours in order to get comfortable enough with it so that I could play it and remain relaxed. This concept of practicing very slowly while visualizing how it will feel to play faster and remain completely relaxed allows your mind to learn the movements at a safe, calm pace and really connect with the piece on a deep level. It also helped me memorize the selection in less than 5 practice sessions. If you haven't adopted this regimen to your practice routine, I highly recommend it. Practice slowly in order to play fast. In addition to the technical and groove aspects, this piece uses a delay effect on the sound that is set to the tempo of the piece. Not knowing exactly how to accomplish this, I had to do some research and experiment with many different sounds and delays to get just the sound I was looking for. We are playing at 135 beats per minute, so I set the delay at this tempo so that every time I play one note, it echoes back. Take a listen. Using this effect requires very steady time. If I were to slow down while playing, the effect wouldn't work. An interesting quirk is that while preparing this piece, I noticed that I needed to tap my left foot on beats 2 and 4 in order to really feel the groove and keep the time. I would call this an example of a way to use your body language or movement to create the right feel. This piece is blazing fast and pretty short, so buckle up and hang on. Here we present Tea Time by the band Wolfpack.
All right, thank you very much. Once again, the title of that last song was Tea Time, featuring our musical director on keyboards, chief musician, Justin Cody. I'm musician first class, Corey Parker. I'm one of the lead vocalists for the Navy Band Cruisers, and I have been in the band for 9 years now. I absolutely love performing in this ensemble, and I enjoy the opportunity to play with world-class musicians on a daily basis. Dedication to your craft, profession, or instrument is paramount in the early years or stages of your career. One must make a decision daily to remain committed and determined to accomplish the goal they have set. Desire, passion, practice, collaboration, and patience are just a few of the great building blocks you will need to build your musical foundation upon. Mentally train yourself to use these building blocks, and you will find yourself achieving your pursuits and all you endeavor. One of the many great aspects of this particular band is performing multiple genres of music within one single concert. This showcases our versatility and reaches audiences of every age, ethnicity, and making the band and the show enjoyable and relatable to all who attend. The majority of what we play in this band is popular music, and sometimes we'll perform arrangements of well-known top 40 pop songs with a cool twist. Arrangements are a great way of expressing our creativity on an existing work. It's like saying, I love this song, now here's my spin on it. Now we'll perform a song by the late, great Michael Jackson, Working Day and Night. First, we're going to perform the original version for 1 minute, then an arrangement of the same song by a group called the Bottom 40 Band. This is Working Day and Night, Michael Jackson.
Sugar, you got me working day and night. Scratch my shoulder, it's aching, make it feel alright. When this is over, loving you will be so right.
All right, so playing the same song in a different style, as you'll see next, can allow for a more personalized expression that is still complementary to the original piece. In other words, when you change the style, you can do your thing. You can change the chords to sound more hip, you can add more rhythmic and harmonic horn lines, and play or sing more cool licks, like we'll show you now. So please enjoy this arrangement of Michael Jackson's Working Day and Night by the Bottom 40 Band. Ooh, my sugar, you got me working tonight. Scratch my shoulder, it's aching, make it feel alright. When this is over, loving you will be so right. I often wonder if loving you will be tonight. Soon enough, darling, this love will be reality. How can you live, girl? 'Cause not for us was meant to be. Yeah, yeah. You must be seeing some other guy instead of me. Oh, working, baby, oh, you got me working day and night, day and night, baby, 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 you got me working now.
Good afternoon. I'm musician first class, Manuel Pelayo, and I would like to talk about how important it is to have a clear goal and put in the effort to achieve that pursuit. Working hard and being disciplined helped me get where I am today. I was born in Cuba, and I consider myself fortunate because I was surrounded by a very supportive environment within my family and with teachers that gave me the best of themselves and motivated me to achieve excellence. They could see something in me that I wasn't able to see, but I was willing to listen to them and put in the necessary work to get better at my instrument and at music in general. At the age of 16, I decided to leave my hometown and go to the capital of Cuba. I didn't have any guarantees for success, but I was determined to succeed anyway. During this time, I kept practicing, listening to music, and taking classes with people that I still admire as musicians and artists today. Havana was my second musical school. I was there that I met many new people and bands that I was able to play with, and as a result, I discovered myself. I acquired the fundamentals of my instrument through the Conservatory of Music, but I didn't have any knowledge about popular music like jazz, Brazilian, or even Cuban styles. I learned about these rhythms on the streets, performing with players that were better than myself, and I learned all I could from them. I want to remind you that your future is in your own hands, and that any choice you make will have consequences, good or bad. Being optimistic is the only attitude that makes sense. Even if you have a bad experience, you will still learn from it. Don't be afraid of failure because you are taking a risk. It will pay in some way in the future. Be perseverant and follow your dreams. I wrote the next piece that we are about to perform. I was inspired by a melody of a musician and friend that I admire, Julio Padrón. The work is a combination of some of the different musical experiences that I was exposed to during my younger days. You will hear elements of samba from Brazil, timba from Cuba, and funk. The next selection is named after my friend's last name. Now enjoy Padrón. Thank you.
All right, now we'll open it up for a few questions. We have a question from Mark Chen, and the question is, I always thought military bands played marches. When did they become rock bands? Well, as long as the Navy's been around, sailors have been playing the popular music of the day. But around 1970 is when the first Navy rock band came about, and that was the Port Authority Rock Band. And they were created with the purpose to recruit more people into the military. And interestingly enough, they used to actually go and play out in civilian attire on the streets to kind of drum up some positive vibes for the Navy.
This next question is from TJ Fryman. It says, I play in a band apart from school. Are there any rehearsal tips for how to plan a rehearsal so we get the most done? Well, just like my friend Manuel Palayo said earlier, it's good. You have to set a goal. You have to have a goal in mind. So I'm right here. So you have to have a goal in mind. So that being said, what is the purpose of rehearsal? To get ready for the performance. Make sure you have charts, and that'll make it so that the rehearsal time isn't wasted on doing jam sessions and playing around and stuff. Just have a goal in mind, have arrangements ready so that you can get everything you need to get done in preparation for your performance.
This next question is from Mike Crochet. What is the most unusual place the Navy ever had you perform? I'd have to say we did this huge gig in Ambon, Indonesia. Just was like a block party almost, and it was just insane. The energy was super high. It's kind of like a weird little gig. It was fun though.
The next question comes from Haley Quinn. She asks, what kinds of things should I practice to be able to join a band like the Cruisers? Well, as mentioned earlier, our band is very versatile in that we play different styles of music, sometimes in one single gig. And so one unique thing about our band is that you have to be good in all styles of music. So my suggestion for you is practice all the styles of music, rock, soul, jazz, Latin, because at some point you're going to have to play those styles and play them well.
This next one is from Jacob Drake. How did you learn to play your instrument? Well, I learned from school, from Prince George's County Public School System, and most of us, we played in elementary school band, middle school band, and eventually high school band, and then all of our paths vary, but most of us started playing in school situations, just like yourself.
Next question is from Matt Boren, and the question is, what are some of the more memorable performances in your Navy music careers? For me, one of my most memorable performances when I was able to deploy with the USNS Hospital Ship Mercy in 2006 for the first Pacific Partnership. We traveled to Indonesia and all over the Philippines and Bangladesh and Australia. And it was a really eye-opening experience as a native Wisconsin-born person to go that far overseas to some of these remote islands and play for some of the local people there that, you know, I distinctly remember one time we played at an orphanage, and it was literally the first time these children had ever seen an American, let alone someone in uniform. And we were able to go there and just bring some positive times for them by playing for them.
This next question is from Susan Pruden. When did you start playing music, and how long have you been playing? I started playing music when I was 10 years old, and I've been playing for 24 years.
And for 38 years.
I started guitar when I was 14, and about 15 years.
Yeah, so I got my first drum kit when I was 10 years old, and I've never looked back. So for me, 19 years almost.
I have been playing for about 21 years.
I have been playing piano for 31 years. I started piano when I was 7 years old, and then I started bassoon and saxophone when I was 10.
I started singing when I was in middle school. Did a lot of singing growing up in church. If you have any more questions, or if you have downloaded the show, send your questions to NavyMusicInTheSchools@gmail.com, and we'll get your answers.
Hello. I'm musician first class Athos De Lima, and I want to thank you all for tuning in today. We'd like to close out our performance with a tune called Run for Cover by Marcus Miller and David Sanborn. You know, it takes the right mindset to learn any instrument, but as we've talked about, it takes even more positive attitude and discipline to take your instrument to another level and completely out of its basic role while at the same time making it sound good. That is what bassist Marcus Miller did with this piece that we're about to play. Not only is the bassist's main role as the musical foundation highlighted, the bass is also showcased as a solo instrument, both in fingering styles and in the style known as slapping. Please enjoy Run for Cover. Thank you.